Amante te vote e mia vinoi. Good greetings from all my relations to all your relations. My name is Kate and I'm a board member at ECWA. I'd like to open this meeting by inviting a moment of reflection about these lands and the people it belongs to. Long before the settler state and before this place came to be colonially known as Durham, North Carolina, these were and have always been the lands of the Eno and Okanichi people, in addition to the Catawba, the Sapani, and the Tuscarora peoples, who have inhabited the greater region surrounding us. These peoples have lived with this land since time immemorial, and I'm here to pay respect to these people's past, present, future, and continued presence on these lands. I'm here to acknowledge the indigenous people who have and continue to live and work in our communities. I'm here to recognize the historic and continued violence against indigenous people by the state and by this nation. And though colonization has done its best to erase the indigenous legacies and histories of these lands, we're present in this moment, recognizing that we're guests and settlers on what has always been Eno and Okanichi lands. At ECWA and as environmentalists, we have the great responsibility and privilege of supporting and carrying on the stewardship of these native lands. Thank you.
I'm Ricky White, and I'm the Executive Director of Ellerbe Creek Watershed Association, and I want to welcome you to our 2020 virtual annual meeting. Now, obviously, we had to do things differently this year. This is recorded just before the election, and I'm feeling a lot of anxiety about the world right now. I'm sure y'all are too. So a lot of the discussion today is going to be around resilience and building resilience. The way that I build resilience personally is I take walks like this in the rocks daily, and I bump into all kinds of cool nature and people, and it just gives me hope and it helps my mind settle down. One of the things that I especially like is when I bump into a box turtle on the trail at Glenstone, for instance, because they're just this really cool ancient relic species that persists in these habitats for decades. They're extremely resilient creatures. They can live for about the same amount of time as a human. Some species of turtles even more. And so I love that about them. I love that they're this kind of ancient historical piece that's within our preserves that we protect. But they also face a lot of challenges around roads that are being built and around development that's really affecting their habitat. So humans have a role in helping them build additional resilience so these populations can persist. And I think that's a really good metaphor for what ECWA is trying to do and should be doing. We need to be building resilience for our human and environmental communities in the watershed. Now, how do we do that? Well, our mission is protect, restore, and engage, right? And so, but in order to do all that with this lens of resilience, we also need to think about the challenges that we're facing. And a lot of those are global challenges, but they have local solutions. And the big challenge that we're all facing and that we have for our entire lives, but we are really recognizing it more now, is systemic racism. And so we're really trying to understand and figure out how ECWA can be an anti-racist organization, especially when you think about all of the things that are tied to systemic racism and the problems that are exacerbated by it, whether it be flooding, which impacts black and brown communities more than the rest of the city's residents in terms of being able to be resilient when your basement or your first floor floods. In terms of nature access, where we don't have nature preserves in Goose Creek or in Bragtown, which are historically African American neighborhoods. And in terms of just in general, working across communities in Durham, where ECWA has been a very white organization and our community is not very white. It involves a lot of black and Hispanic folks. In fact, our watershed is majority minority. So finding ways to listen to the environmental issues that those communities are facing and bring them into our coalition and to in our watershed association and make everyone feel like it's their watershed association. And so this is a really powerful but very challenging and difficult thing to do, but we're up for the task. And so I hope that you'll see through the presentations that we do today, the ways that we're building resilience and the ways that we're reaching out to new community partners like Urban Community Agronomics and Durham Children's Initiative and Seeds and a lot of community advocates that Keisha Satterwhite, our community engagement specialist, has been doing an amazing job of working with. You know, this is the theme of this whole annual meeting this year is resilience and supporting one another and getting us through this really difficult time. I'm really excited that y'all are here and joined us. This is your watershed association. I want to make sure my hope and my wish that is that everyone that's tuning in leaves with a sense of additional purpose, understands how you can get involved in your watershed association, either through working on a committee or task force, donating to our End of Year campaign, or even volunteering a work day. And my hope is also that you leave this with some optimism and some understanding that we can make a difference locally and that can end up creating a chain reaction that allows us to tackle some of these really difficult issues globally. So thank you for joining and enjoy.